boys and girls, how are you? I'm fine. I'm excited in Jesus. And I'm born again. I love Jesus as my personal savior. Are you born again? I know some of you have said yes, others not sure, others no. But I pray that God is going to help all of us to trust in Him, to believe in Him, so that we have salvation, and then we'll live with God forever and ever and ever. Today, we are going to go through our Bible lesson, and it's so important to hear from God every day, because God is our Heavenly Father, God is our everything, God is our all in all, and we want to hear from Him every passing minute, every passing hour, every passing second, every time. Today, our lesson is about God's covenant with Abraham. God's covenant with Abraham. God made a promise to Abraham. And this promise was made to Abraham because God loves people. God loves people. God loves you. God loves me. God loves every boy. God loves every girl. No matter what, no matter our backgrounds, no matter how we look like, no matter our size, no matter our height, God loves us so much. And we see Him choosing one man by the name Abraham and making a great promise to him, making a covenant with him. Abraham was born in a place called Ur, a place called Ur. That was his homeland. And God chose him to bless him. And He told him, Abraham, go out of your land, your relatives, and your father's house. Imagine, you're told to relocate to a place you do not know. He was told to go to a place that he had no clue where it was, but God promised to be with him and to lead him. So Abraham, because he loved God, what did he do? He obeyed and he followed the instructions of God. And God had told him, I will bless you. And you will become a blessing to many. You will become a blessing, not just to your family, no, but to many people on the earth. In Genesis chapter 15, we see God making the covenant with Abraham. And it came in a vision, and God told Abraham that He will bless him with a great nation. He will bless him with a great nation. Do you know the name that Abraham used to use before? We normally know him a lot by the name Abraham. His name was Abram. But God changed his name to Abraham, the name that we normally refer him to with. And Abraham means a father of a multitude, a father of a great nation. Abraham and his wife, Sarah, didn't have a single son, not even one. They didn't have a child, but God promised to bless them and to bless them with a great nation. So Abraham, because he had faith in God and he loved God, he believed in God. First, you see, he moved from where he was living to a land that was not known to him because he trusted in God and he had faith in God. And then he continued to trust God that he was going to fulfill his promise. And you know what, boys and girls? God fulfilled his promise. God brought to pass the covenant that he made with Abraham. And later, many, many years down the lane, we see Jesus was born in the family of Abraham. Have you ever read Matthew chapter 1? What does it say? It says, this one begot this one was the son of this one was the son of this one. So you see, Abraham got a son by the name of Isaac. Then Isaac got a son by the name of Jacob. Then Jacob got many sons, and on and on and on until we get to Jesus. So Jesus was born in the family of Abraham. And God fulfilled the promise of Abraham that He'll bless nations through him. So we are blessed because of Jesus. Because Jesus came and died for us, that when we believe in him, we become children of God. And because we are children of God, and Jesus was born in the line of Abraham, then we have the blessing of Abraham. And that is how God blessed Abraham, by calling him a father of multitude. And it came to pass by Jesus being born in his family, and all of us who believe in Jesus becoming part of that family. And the family is so wide and so big. Just think of the many people who know Lord Jesus Christ as their Savior. All those people, the Church of Christ, we are a family. And all of us, we say we are from Father Abraham, because the promise was fulfilled. God fulfills his promise, and God fulfills his promise to those who are obedient. Because boys and girls, if you don't obey God, you will not allow him to work in your life. Like if Abraham was sent and he refused to go, God will not have been able to direct him to the right place. But if you obey God, he will be able to fulfill that good plan he has for you in your life. Because God does not change. He's constant. He does not change. It is us who change. It is us who do things that are not pleasant. But we should always ask God, like Abraham, help us to follow you so that your promise can be so true in our lives. So that whatever you have said in your word can be so real in our lives. Let's pray and ask God to help us to be obedient to him and to know that his promise will be fulfilled in us as we follow him every day. Dear God, we thank you. Thank you for every boy and every girl. Thank you because you're going to fulfill your promise in us as we obey you, oh dear God. Help us to obey you every single day, every passing hour, every passing week. Help us to obey you all the days of our lives and to follow you like Abraham did. Even when we mess, help us, oh God, to repent and ask you to help us to do the right thing. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen, amen, amen. Thank you, boys and girls. Till next lesson. Bye-bye.